What's up, y'all? So today, I'm gonna do the same thing I always do. What's that? Propagate into the realm, as always, right? So, what are we gonna talk about today? Well, for starters, yes, I know. It's one of those days, not done up, looking rough, you know. My apologies for the hands, but you know. Just go with it. So, let's talk, shall we? Do you know that we are living fake lives? All of us, we're living fake lives. I've been called fake. And I have actually come to terms and accepted the fact that, yeah, I am being pretty fake. I'm pretending. I'm playing a role. I'm playing MiKa’El. Still.
This is the briefing room. It's where the president holds most of his press conference.
Even professional politicians have some trouble getting used to all the cameras and the
teleprompter.
What?
The teleprompter, is it hooked up?
No, I don't think so. Nobody expects you to be Bill Mitchell overnight. The most important thing to remember is his general presence.
Presence?
Right. President Mitchell always has one hand in the pocket of his coat.
That's at a press conference. Otherwise, they're almost always on the podium.
No, I'm not certain about that.
An America prouder than the one we found.
There. Right there, on the podium. Except on America when he points.
You know, that is very good.
America isn't what we say here tonight. It's in the faces and smiles. It's in the gentle kindness.
But that is only to get through the daily nuances of dealing with people. Because when you get to a certain level, people won't understand you. They won't get you at all. They'll try to pretend, they'll downplay, they'll talk about you negatively, all this, that, and the third. Instead of trying to embrace what is and trying to get to your level, they criticize.
What is the matter with you? He started it.
Look what you did, you little jerk.
Kevin, get upstairs right now.
Why?
Kevin, you're such a disease.
Shut up.
Say goodnight, Kevin.
Goodnight, Kevin.
So, instead of dealing with that energy, we play the role.
I'm not playing a role. I'm my name. I am who I am supposed to be.
Are you certain? A name you were given, or did you choose it? A position you were given, or did you choose it?
I chose my life career path.
Are you certain? Look back. Really take in the details of your life, if you can recall. And realize that you've been pushed along the way to where you are. Same as me. We're being captivated by the stimuli. Now, a lot of people don't realize that they are cogs in this big pyramid, but you're cogs. That's all you will ever be, because that's what this pyramid scheme is. And I say scheme because it's pulled the wool over so many people's eyes for so long. People don't want to accept it. I watched a video of which someone was talking about how their family members were a part of the order, but they weren't bad people. Good and evil are just constructs. So, I would not say that they're evil, but if you are in the order, no matter at what level, you are a part of the pyramid to the degree of which you worship somebody. You're always looking up to the next person above you to pull you up, while at the same time crapping on the person below you. Because it rolls downhill, doesn't it? That's what it's supposed to do. Treat people poorly. But when you're a part of this order, that energy in itself is the order. This is why managers, enforcers of the law, folks who are supposed to uphold the system, teachers, This is why they act the way they do. This is why they put people in their place.
All right, sir. Are you stepping out? Are you stepping out of the car?
I'd like to exercise my First Amendment. You can give me my information back, please.
I'll give it back out here. Step outside the car, I'll give you this information.
You can just put it right here through the window, sir. I'm gonna protect my Fourth Amendment right.
Oh,
you're a good police officer, all right? I know you, I can see it in your eyes. You just said you were. Okay, you're a good trooper, I can see it in your eyes. I know you wanna uphold your oath. Somebody's telling you to do this, all right?
Sir, here is your passport card. I wrote 17, listen to me.
I'm listening, yeah, you got my attention.
Three of them are must appear to carry jail time. You're gonna have to go to court for them. The other ones are payable. You can pay them, go to court, set up for a payment plan, or go to court guilty or not guilty. There's also going to be an application for charges for failure to obey a lawful order. You're going to get a warrant for your arrest if you don't come to court when requested to do so. You can take those. You are not free to go. You cannot drive. You cannot travel. If you do so again, you may be subject to arrest.
I need my plate back, too. Y'all stole my plate.
That's being seized as evidence. You're not getting that back.
So you're stealing my property, then? All right, I don't accept the ticket. I don't accept any contracts. I don't accept.
I know you won't take it, but that way it's affixed to your vehicle, so you have it.
He put all the tickets and stuff outside my automobile.
Am I correct in assuming you are no longer a U.S. citizen?
I'm a national, sir.
Passport ID cards for U.S.
citizens. No. I'm a national. I am a national. You stole my passport card, too. Stole my passport card, too.
Because that's what's supposed to happen. It's energy harvesting. It's sacrifices. They know their job. Protect the system at all costs. But that's just the way it is. You have to look at how we've been structured for so long. Look at a classroom setting. You can tell who's at the head of the class. Who's at the head of the boardroom table? It's a pyramid. Get with it. You're a part of it, whether you realize it or not, because either you are already in it by initiation or by blood, or you're someone who doesn't have either of those to fall back on. You're just a regular person, right? Well, you play into this system, so technically you are a part of it, even if you don't know it or realize it. Good luck. Now, back to the fakeness of it all. For me, I pretend to be MiKa’El. Again, I'm trying to communicate with people without having to be, oh my God, you know so much. Who are you? Who are you? Well, if you've ever watched any of these videos, deep down inside, underneath the surface level of this vessel, this polymer, who am I? You know exactly who I am.
We found it. I don't know how we missed it before. It's too much power for one object. We need two.
It'll need to be something smaller.
Come, see for yourself.
Not until you tell me who you are.
You know who I am.
Who you really are. The last man to bear your crest died over 1,000 years ago. He had no heir.
I told you I found this on a dead man.
Tell me your name.
I have had many names.
I've stated this multiple times. You may not believe it, but you want to know something? I don't care. Because I know. But with that, I get why we pretend, I understand, because we're trying to get along with the go along. But at a certain point, you can no longer pretend. Like for me, at a certain point, I will have to level set. I will have to show my true nature. But until that time, I'm just going to continue to pretty much live a standard, regular life, you know, enjoying it, understanding the nuances of who I am now opposed to who I once was. And a lot of this journey gets kind of confusing. It can be overwhelming. It can be a bit much because you don't realize that you're changing. Your whole mindset is changing. You're not that same person. So there's going to be conflicts in between. You're conflicted by the old you or your persona opposed to the new persona, the new person you are.
You're remarkably calm right now.
Hey, sometimes your exes try to kill you. What can you do, you know? You want a party?
No, this isn't me.
Shandi, are you okay?
This is getting weird.
Get out.
What's her problem?
My problem? My problem is that I used to be you.
This isn't a born-again thing, is it?
No, she's future you.
Makes sense. So what happens to me?
What do you mean?
Look, Shandi, let's get out
of... No. I want to hear what I have to say to myself. What did you mean, what happens to me?
Well, evidently, I become a total frigid bitch, so I just wanted to know what's up.
Oh, you mean I stop sitting around smoking drugs from a broken light bulb all day?
Guys, maybe we should...
Yeah, you're lame now. You used to have fun.
I used to be useless.
What?
The most memorable thing you ever did was get captured by your smoked-out ex.
That's not true.
I'm sorry, and fucking half of Stillwater. Go team.
I always thought you were just really friendly and hated pants.
Someone gets it.
I hate me. Let's get out of here.
Not vessel-wise, but inside. So, how are you actually getting through this life? How are you navigating through the matrix itself? So, like, we really have to get to the point where we realize that this society is not on the right footing. That's completely off. Our society is built to enslave, make people cogs, submit. They realize what light and sound does to you. This is why they push it on you so hard and heavy. Anything created after 2022 is heavily influenced by lighting and sound. Beforehand, it was just sound and somewhat lighting with color schemes and patterns. But now it's overwhelmingly to the point where we know we got to figure out the frequencies of controlling these people. We got to figure out the light frequencies of controlling these people. AI, help us. And it has. So now you're sitting up here on social media. You're sitting up here on these devices, same as me, mind you. I'm not going to belittle you. Taking in this light, this frequency, this code. And you don't believe that that can be an overwhelming thing that an organization can do. But you've never seen your government in its clandestine affairs. If you knew what this government did, what most governments do,
Ted Kaczynski was a recluse who hated technology so much that he attempted to reverse the negative effects of the Industrial Revolution by killing 3 people and injuring 23 more. How did he end up like that? We can't ignore what happened at Harvard University in 1959. When Kaczynski was a 17-year-old sophomore there, he signed up for a strange psychological experiment. He and 21 other students were asked to write down their most personal beliefs and opinions. Kaczynski and the other students were strapped to chairs rigged with electrodes and blinded with bright lights. Then they were forced to debate their beliefs with law students, who were told to be as nasty and abusive as possible. After the test subjects were thoroughly humiliated, they were forced to watch recordings of the entire affair. This went on for 3 years. When Kaczynski was later connected to Harvard, the files related to the experiment were permanently sealed.
You would stop listening. Completely. You wouldn't care. Be your own citizen. Because why would you allow an NPC, a sim, this simulation itself, to control you? You wield the authority, right? You are a part of the whole, same as me. You create. But that's easier said than done for a lot of people at this point. They've been mentally screwed for so long. Anxiety, depression, all that stuff is taking full effect on people. Worried about where they're going to get their next paycheck, worried about somebody else's issues. All that doesn't matter. What really matters is how you perceive, how you take in all of this inside, and how you propagate it back out, making the world around you a little bit more palatable. So, with that, if you are still living at the whims of the Matrix, good luck, okay? They're changing so much, they're trying to be 1984 like there's no tomorrow.
The forces of darkness and the treasonable maggots who collaborate with them must, can, and will. They must stamp them out! We, the people of Oceania, and our traditional allies to the eternal enemy of Oceania. Death! Death!
Brothers and sisters.
But I really don't think you have that juice to get there. You know why I don't think you have that juice? Because I didn't give you that juice. We're following a role. You're going to follow your role. I'm speaking to the order at this point. You're going to follow your roles as they were laid out. Which rightfully so, you're trying to do very well, which, kudos. But I can assure you that your rumors of wars are in lockstep with where we're going. So, kudos on that end. I love it. I love it. Keep going. Keep going. Now, with that, I really don't have too much to talk about. I don't. I mean, what needs to be said? We can talk about emotions. We can talk about politics. Politics. We can talk about a wide variety of things, but what difference would it actually make in regards to you? Unless you're taking it all in, you're just continuing this fake lifestyle that we've been given. You have to realize that this is a different world. You're in a different realm. It's not like it used to be. And I'm not telling you to go out there and not care for your loved ones or your friends. I'm just saying you have a soul family out there, a connection to other entities, other vessels, other beings, closer than what you actually realize. So take heart. You have an entire family out there. Just waiting for you. We have returned. You shouldn't fear. You shouldn't be scared, and you should embrace yourselves. Now, with all that being said, I hope that you got through this little rant with a little bit of insight, or just, you know what? He's on to something. He's just like me.
I like the cut of your jib.
What's a jib?
Promote that man.
And if that's the case, hello, Reflection. How are you? Now, with that being said, if you are still living a fake life, not knowing you're living a fake life, you need to realize who you are. If you're living a fake life and you're enlightened, I get it. You're just trying to have a normal conversation. No worries. As long as you know, that's all that matters. But energy-wise, a lot of these folks now are going to have negative energy, negative vibes, and they're going to try to get to you. They need that high vibrations to make them feel comfortable. But do not let them become leeches, because that's what they will become on you. Level set if you must. Live life. Live this journey in your own right. And please, once again, don't fear a thing. Now, with that out the way, I hope you were able to get through a lot of this rant and convolution, because I was trying to get through it like there's no tomorrow, but we made it. So, with a smile on and positive vibes your way, for the light workers, keep doing your thing. For the chosen, stay on mission. And for those who know, let's get it.